classroom. Sufi poet Rumi, I'm pretty sure it is actually, and it's such a beautiful poem that wants to whisper into our ears, draw near, let me whisper into your ear the name whose radiance makes the spheres to dance, and the name is Om.
That's decide. What we said.
If you get it, it's a very nice melody written by Anubhava, I think, one of our beautiful one of our show's musicians from back then.
Shiva.
Stay.
Just wanna.
Huh? You wanna speak? Play one more.
Okay. That was B.
Yeah.
Samastha. How are you folks today? How are we? What's the weather report?
Oh, it rained so much last night here. So much. And just wanted to say something because... Yes.
Well, David was telling me that our good friends Debbie and Louise were emailing and talking. Hi, guys. And there was something that got misunderstood yesterday, and we really want to clear it up. And that is that the impression that we don't have a sense of the great spirit, the godliness that it exists in all of us, because we said something about God.
We don't believe in God.
We don't believe. That's what we said. Yeah. And you know, you can't chant all these mantras and not feel God. You just cannot. Of course, different religions have different ways of seeing the Great Spirit, and I just wanted to clear that up. You know, because I see God in you. I see godliness in everybody,
and you did say
even Deva.
and you did say you don't believe in a guy in the sky with a beard. That's where it came from, that kind of concept of one entity that is God. So that was the misunderstanding.
Yeah.
And
but thank you for sharing that, Debbie. And you know, we're grateful to clear that up, because how can we possibly not feel godliness when we're in this space with you guys? We are blessed more than words can ever say, and that can only be a result of our connection with the Great Spirit. And we are very, very blessed to be in the loving hands of the Great Spirit.
Yeah, that was also basically the mantra the mantra of the mantra meditation journey today. It's Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, which means Om is the name inside of me, which is the way of the oneness of all things, which is exactly that.
Would you like to sing that?
No, not now.
Okay.
because that's really that flame, that God, that divine flame that we all are and carry. And
love is the fire.
Yeah,
divine flame.
After.
Burning in the night. No, I'm not going to sing it now. I'm just referencing it, you know, like, I'm not going to actually sing it.
I was...
Sometimes life is a little too wild for Deva. Sometimes. Sometimes.
It's a little too ordered for me.
Oh my God.
We actually have a name for our beautiful cat now. And it's beautiful because on that day that we all sang for Anna, the beautiful animal communicator that we are friends with and who was going to read our little cat. Actually, when we sang for her that day, she was reading the cat, and we hadn't actually synchronized it like that. It just happened. So it was a beautiful synchronistic moment, and she was so grateful to receive Om Triambakam, which has been with her for 20 years, one of her really close to her heart mantras.
Thank you for chanting and singing that for Anna. Yeah. It's really important. She needs our support right now, and she's a beautiful soul.
So she read the kitty, and the question, amongst other questions, was we also wanted the kitty to know that we're not going to stay here forever, and just so she, you know, that she's mentally prepared, and she is, and you know where she's going to go afterwards. We've got it kind of sorted. And she asked about the name, and the little cat conveyed to her that she wanted to not have a name of a deity, which was very surprising, but she wanted to have a name that reflected her lightness and gave her trust and calmness. Anyway, I just let that percolate, and yesterday the name Sachi came, and Sachi is, it came more with the sound first, and the meaning is so beautiful. It comes from a Japanese name that it's Sachiko, which is a child of bliss or colorful wisdom, which I think is great for a cat. And then it also is has an Indian origin, Sanskrit, and it's grace, it's truth, it's actually also companion. And so she's our little Sachi now. So thank you so much for, there was just a message from Louise. Thank you, Louise. Thank you for all the names you sent. I think you must have had 1,000 names, and I wonder, maybe there was a Sachi amongst the names, but thank you so much for your care and for your...
This beautiful journey with this little guy, you know. And since she had that talk with Anna, and almost since that very time, she is now amazingly integrated in a totally different way. We even gave her a little leaf of salad today, and she ate the salad. She just smelt it for a bit, then she took it and she ate the salad, which was for me very surprising.
She's also vegan, amongst not being vegan, she's also vegan.
No, she's not. She eats these horrible cat biscuits, but that's okay. But she's totally integrated. Right now she's made herself a home on a floor mat in the kitchen, and that's our power spot. And she's just
really
laying there. She has another nice spot that she has under the couch on the deck, especially when it's stormy and thunder and lightning here. She likes to go under there. She doesn't like to come inside, though, for so long. Shall we do a meditation?
And today let's also dedicate the meditation to Gloria, who just was just born today, a little girl called Gloria.
Oh.
And so there's kind of two births. experimenting with that sound of Om or Aum. Today we chant Aum, and you just follow your bliss, follow that which feels, which gives you the most comfort, is the most natural to you.
I'll just say a little more about our meditation, because the more that I hear it from myself, when I was first coming into meditation, the more it helped me. And I know that there are some of us who are, me included, who are new to meditation, even though I've been meditating for 40 years now. There's still a mysterious quality to it. And there is a doorway into a sense of peace. And sometimes there's, it's funny to say a shortcut, but there are signposts that mentally that we can take note of. And I just want to talk to you about that if you're just beginning to meditate. So the best way for us to do this is to actually get ready to meditate. So as we usually do, we come, get comfortable, and then when you're comfortable, straighten up your spine and close your eyes.
Do we have to take our hats off when we meditate?
No.
No?
No. You can meditate anywhere wearing any clothes. You don't have to be a sadhu up in the Himalayas. You can meditate in a nightclub if you want. The noise is just a device, and it's a very beautiful device. It helps us to realize that there is only silence. When we connect with that space, there's just only silence. And everything that we hear is filled with that, in that silence. But the silence itself is never disturbed. So your eyes are closed, and I want you to sit for a little while like this, just with your eyes closed and with your back straight. I want you to see what is the first thing that you become aware of. Is it the breath? That you, if you don't breathe, if you hold it because you're feeling, you're concentrating on closing your eyes, take a breath. We begin to feel air around us, on our bodies, on our arms and our hands and our faces, becoming tuned in and slowing down to reality. Do you begin to hear? Begin to listen. In the same way as the eyes can see for a long way, so the ears can hear for a long way also. Not just the immediate sounds, but if you really focus on listening for a while, you'll forget your mind. And then your mind eventually will come back to you. It does. But then let it go again, like as if you're watching a cloud in the sky, and then you watch beyond the cloud into the blue sky, the never-ending empty sky. to bring a smile in your meditation now, either on your face or in your belly. This is a smile of gratitude. To chant the mantra Om with Deva, fill in our silent sanctuary with the sacred holy mantra Om.
Take a deep breath together. sounds with our bodies, including our bodies, our arms, our voices. Let this mantra fill the whole of our bodies, the whole room, the whole planet, the whole galaxy, celebrating the seven chakras, the seven realms, seven levels of consciousness.
Open, close your eyes and feel the connection with your brothers and sisters across the world. temple door. I'm seeing myself like I never did before. I'm seeing myself through the eyes of an angel. Through the eyes of an angel.
Too low. We have to come up. Sorry, guys. We're just spending some quality time with you here.
Moonlight streaming through this temple door. I'm seeing myself like I never did before. I'm seeing myself through the eyes of an angel. Through the eyes of an angel. Twilight on the mighty Ganga, wood smoke in the air, Deva standing next to me, singing the Gayatri Mantra, singing love is the only prayer, love is the only. Through the eyes of an angel, through the eyes of the Blessed One, through the eyes of an angel, well, here we stand naked in the evening sun, and we're blessing the earth that we stand upon, and we're watching the holy river run, and we fly. There's a pilgrim beneath the ancient banyan tree. Is that somebody else? Well, it could be me. Somebody living the mystery. We're all living the mystery. Through the eyes of the Blessed One, through the eyes of an angel, oh, here we stand naked in the Costa Rican sun, and we're blessing the earth that we stand upon. Yes, we're completing the things that we left undone. And I turn and face the man I have become. And I Krishna Sukhino Bhavantu Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shanti, shanti.
Namaste. Good night, good day. See you tomorrow.